Hi, everybody. Welcome to Evening TV. I'm Evening Ransom. Some time ago, I talked to you about a book called Children of the Self-Absorbed. A sequel has been made called Children of the Aging Self-Absorbed. And so I wanted to talk to you a little bit about that. So the Children of the Self-Absorbed, in the cover, it says, A Grown-Up's Guide to Getting Over Narcissistic Parents. And on Children of the Aging Self-Absorbed, it says, A Guide to Coping with Difficult Narcissistic Parents and Grandparents. I have always had this hope, this belief that, you know, they would mellow. And part of this came from the fact that I had such sweet grandparents and believed that, you know, that had to be around the pike eventually, right? No, it didn't. And it never was going to manifest. I was never going to have, my parents were never going to morph into anything close to remotely like my grandparents. And so things are not predictable to me. So like when I was going through my divorce, the way that my parents behaved was not predictable to me, because I thought, you know, even if it wasn't all about just this is my daughter and I'm loyal to her and I take her side and all those good reasons to do that, I love her and, you know, I'm her mom and dad, all those good reasons. But even if not that, my parents, I would think, have thought that they would have thought that they didn't want their daughter to just get wiped out and devastated in the divorce. They wanted her to get a fair and equitable divorce, and they wanted her to stay in good, they wanted to maintain a good relationship with their one and only daughter, because if I was in, had a good relationship with them and I was financially stable, I would be better equipped to take care of them as they got into old age. This is my logical thinking. So it made no sense to me at all when they were jumping on board with my ex-husband and trying to just wipe me out, trying to like take advantage of my divorce and steal from me and do all this kind of crazy stuff. Take out of it all the things about love and loyalty and right and wrong. They were very much in a fight mode about, obviously they had a paranoia about getting older. They didn't feel that they could count on me. So they just saw it as a chance that they had to take advantage of me, that they had to try and take advantage where they could, because they couldn't count on me to want to take care of them, because we project. They didn't want to take care of me, so they just assumed that it was a dog-eat-dog world, and that I felt the same way, and I wouldn't take care of them because they didn't want to take care of me, and they didn't want to take care of their parents, and blah, blah, blah. So, you know, they were busy just stealing, even from me, and even from their parents. You know, my parents stole my inheritance from my grandmother, and they were trying to take my home. They were trying to do all kinds of crazy stuff, and it ended up benefiting my ex-husband a ton. They ended up making him tons of money and helping him out a great deal, and then he discarded them. Which, you know, he just sees them as idiots because they played right into his hands and he doesn't have any need for them anymore. So he completely used them. And he told my son just recently that he has no interest in having them in his life. That he told my son, if you want to have a relationship with them, go ahead. But I don't have any reason to have them in my life. That's what he told them. So, you know, it was just all around bad planning, even from a really manipulative, narcissistic standpoint. It just didn't make any sense. But this book kind of explains why that might have been. And it breaks down that there's these different kinds of aging, self-absorbed parents. And it's really very counterintuitive to a normal thinking person. Basically, there's four types. And there's the clingy type, the suspicious defensive type, the arrogant type, and the belligerent type. And I have figured out that I have between the suspicious defensive and the arrogant. And the suspicious defensive, very much so. Yeah, basically, and if you can figure out what kind of parent you have, then you can figure out how to deal with them and what to basically expect. I'll just give you a quick rundown and see if this helps you out at all. Okay, so there's the clingy type. So the clingy type seeks or seems to seek sympathy from you and others, is demanding of your time and efforts on their behalf, focuses on what she does not have, is missing, or is a want, or was wanted, wants constant attention, points out how she is suffering, seeks pity, smothers you with attention, is intrusive, and the like, is in the child role with you, and with you in the adult role, cries easily and often, expects you and others to meet her needs at the expense of your own and others' needs, and carps, complains, and whines. Okay. That's not my parents, no. Now this one, this sounds much more like my parents. Okay. And again, you could do the almost, the never, almost, sometimes, never, frequently, very often, and always, okay? So that one, those ones I would say, those are pretty much nevers. This one, these are almost always. Makes comments that suggest that she's suspicious of your motives and motives of others. Assumes that most negative perceptions, the most negative perceptions of whatever you do or say. Seems to feel that you are deliberately neglecting her. Is overly sensitive to any hint of perceived criticism. Expects you and others to be perfect. Is rigid and unbending. Tends to be very concrete and detailed. Asks numerous questions. Is calculating and manipulative. Keeps others at a distance. Easily takes offense. Okay, that's that one. Now, the arrogant displays a superior attitude, boasts and brags about personal possessions, accomplishments, and the like, takes unearned credit for others' achievements, fails to assume responsibility for mistakes, exhibits an entitlement attitude, oh my gosh, is contemptuous of you and others, is quick to point out others' deficiencies and mistakes, feels that you owe her, assumes she is right and should always receive deference, feels that she has the right to take advantage of others, gives orders and expects prompt compliance, and is sarcastic. Okay, that sounds like both of my parents and my ex-husband. Totally. Okay. And then finally, the belligerent. The belligerent one. Seems angry all the time. Now, this is going to be much more like my ex-husband. Seems angry all the time. Is combative, even about trivial matters. Criticizes and blames you and others for personal discomfort. Is quick to take offense to perceived insults, slights, and the like. Carries grudges. Talks loudly and fast. Interrupts others. Talks over others. Promotes discord and conflict among others. Can be easily angered and teases and taunts others until they become distressed. That was my ex completely. That was my ex. Okay, so basically, this book is just about how to deal with aging narcissists and how to maneuver within the boundaries of these relationships if you must continue carrying them on, if you wish to continue to carry them on. It's kind of a blessing in disguise that this is a learning process and you learn over time, because had I known 15 years ago where this would end up, or that they would just be, there would be no progress, that it would just there would be just nothing learned or gained by any of these family members, it would have been just so sad. It would have just been so sad. And so maybe having that hope and made it so that I stayed a little bit more optimistic. And always willing and open to it, you know, to them making changes. And I always believed that they would. I always believed that they would. I expected any minute I was going to get, all 15 years, I expected any minute I was going to get some kind of call or some kind of letter or something that said, you know, I don't know what we're doing here, you know. You're my daughter. You're my sister. You know, I love you. I don't know what, you know, you're my oldest friend. I don't know what happened. I don't know what I was thinking. We need to talk.